It has been long noted the health of your gums is linked to the health of your entire body. In fact, one recent study found patients with gum disease were more likely to suffer serious complications after contracting COVID-19. September is National Gum Month, and local dentists are taking the opportunity to educate patients on the importance of proper gum care. Dr. Christian Berdy of Berdy Dental Group joins us now with tips on how to keep us smiling and healthy. Good morning.
Good morning. Thank you for having me on this morning.
Absolutely. When it comes to hygiene, why is gum health especially important?
Gum health is very important because that's the first opening to the rest of our body is the mouth. So if patients have a mouth that's diseased, they will really have some problems occurring elsewhere. People who are diabetics, especially if they don't take good care of their teeth, will also have a difficult time managing their diabetes.
Dr. Berdy, so I know this is a conversation that you and I have had several times in the past in person. Unfortunately, this morning it's via Zoom, but it's so nice to see you. What are the best practices to care for your gums?
Well, the best practices are to follow a good regimen twice a day. I urge my patients to get a water pick and use the water pick first to flush out any debris between their teeth, then to go ahead and use our handy floss, which I just brought a little bit of it along with me to show everybody that you use the floss first before the brush. The reason I like them to use the floss first is because most people brush their teeth and then they're done. If they floss first and only floss the teeth that you want to keep, this is a good reminder for them.
Right? Which is all of them.
Yes, it's all of them. And then if they use the brush, on the end of some of the brushes, this little rubber thing that you can see, and this is called a rubber tip stimulator. And what it is to clean underneath the gum line, just like you would clean the cuticle around your nail. You could use the rubber tip to use to clean around the cuticle of the teeth. And if you do that for all the teeth, and then finally brush. And finally, after you brush, use the water pick again. And when you're using the water pick, use it quickly and don't use it on a high setting.
Do not use it on a high setting.
No, it's not a blaster. It's just a flusher.
Oh, see, that's where I must be going wrong. I like when it's on the high setting, that's something to note. Yeah. Also, can you hold up the rubber tip one more time? Maybe with your left hand. It was difficult for us to see. I just want to show our viewers. Exactly. A little down.
Can you see
there
it now?
There you go. Just hold. Yep, right there. Perfect. And that is the rubber tip that you're talking about.
Yes, right here on the end. Yep. And they come separately as well. We have one that's just in a holder on all by itself. I didn't bring one this morning to show. So what you want to do is you want to look, you know, your mouth sometimes doesn't hurt at all. And the signs that you will see is if you're having any bleeding when you're brushing or flossing. You know, if you wash your hands and you start rubbing them together and they start bleeding, you would panic. Well, people don't do that when they clean their teeth. And that's the first sign of inflammation. And inflammation is one of the problems that you have with COVID, is that the body has this inflammatory process and it's very hard for the body to control it. So if you can control the inflammation in your mouth, that will certainly help other things. The other thing that you'll look for is to have some swelling of the gum in an area or two, and you may not even know it, or your gums are a little bit more red than they should be, especially around the neck of the tooth. So you want to go ahead and really make sure that your mouth is healthy. Have your doctor even look in there. Even your physician should be able to look in your mouth and say, you know, you've got a problem, go see your dentist. The thing that I've noticed over this last few months is our patients are staying away too long. They're missing their appointments. They're afraid to come in. So we urge them to keep their appointments and make sure that they're getting a very thorough examination. Make sure that the gums are in good shape so that they can avoid having complications.
And routine is key here with anything.
Routine, twice a day, and frequent cleanings with your hygienist so that you can keep things under good control. And if you have a problem, treat it very early on. Don't wait till it's a major problem.
Absolutely. Dr. Berdy, thank you so much for joining us this morning. We appreciate it.
Thank you for having us. We're